We praise God. We praise God for who he is, hallelujah, and what he is to each one of us, hallelujah. David declares in Psalm 18, I love you, Lord. You are my shield, my buckler, my deliverer, my strength, the horn of my salvation. I don't know what he is to you because he's all of that to me and more. But that great God deserves, hallelujah, a wonderful praise. Hallelujah. There is no better place to be than perfecting church at 3. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I need those radical praisers in here today. Glory to God. Lift your voice. Hallelujah. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Hallelujah. If he's done anything for you, hallelujah, anything for anybody you know, he deserves praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We thank God for all of you being here in person this afternoon, but we also thank God, hallelujah, for the visitors. Glory to God. Let's praise God for our visitors. Glory to God. And while your hands are clapping, let's thank God for those that are in a virtual sanctuary. Amen. Glory to God. Let them know how much we love them, how much we praise God for them. Hallelujah. Joining us this afternoon, we thank God. How many of you are ready to praise God? Hallelujah. Glory to God. I thank God that when I grew up, my mom and them, they would have a layaway. And so you keep paying on it until you would get it. So your praise is that payment. Hallelujah. Sometimes you haven't seen what you were asking God for, but praise him. Hallelujah. In advance. Give him the yet praise. Hallelujah. I don't see it yet, but hallelujah. You're worthy, God. I'm going to give you the praise because I know I'm going to get it. Glory to God. I'm going to press into the praise. I know it's coming. I know my children will be saved. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Press in, press in, press in, and give him everything you got because he's worthy. He's worthy of the praise. Hallelujah. I sought the Lord and he heard me and he delivered me. He delivered me out of all of my distresses. And so I thank him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We honor God today. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. We praise you and we honor you, God. God, we're praising you and thanking you in advance for what you're going to do in the service. God, we thank you for the souls that were saved this morning, those that were delivered, God. But God, we know that you're going to do a new thing. Hallelujah. And we recognize the new thing, God. We thank you, Lord, for all that was poured into us this morning. Now, God, we ask that you would bless our bishop as he comes forth with the word. God, we thank you that the word is already blessed. We thank you, Father God, for the harvest that shall come. Hallelujah. We're excited about the harvest, God. We thank you, Lord, for every soul. Thank you for deliverance, God. Thank you for people being set free. Thank you, Lord, for restoration, God, not only in their body, in their mind, but in their spirit. God, we thank you in the name of Jesus that the enemy has been caught, and we bind him now in the name of Jesus. Lord, you have your way in this place in the name of Jesus. Free course in your praise, free course in the music, free course in your word, God. Do as only you can in here today, God, and we'll be careful to give your name the praise. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Those that agree with that prayer, hallelujah. Hallelujah, give them some praise. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah. Well, this morning, our praise team ushered us into the presence of God, and we know that they're going to do it again. Hallelujah. As they come, let's give them some praise.
Hallelujah. 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 There's something special about the name of Jesus. Something happens when we call on the name of Jesus, that great name. There's power in his name. Amen.
We love to call your name.
We cannot explain
that heaven,
when
power in the name of Jesus. Power in the name. Sing, there is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
So much power.
Power in your name.
Oh, there is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Power in your name, Jesus.
Power in your name.
There is power in the name, Jesus.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Oh, let it call us.
happen when I call his name. Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, now it is the time for us, those youthful members. Hallelujah. Those that can remember they were once a part of PYC's. Glory to God. They're going to come to us now under the dynamic leadership of Amir Healy. We thank God for him. Amen. Let's put our hands together for our young people. PYC's.
Hallelujah. I feel the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. So, I wasn't going to say nothing because I just wanted to get right into it, but I have to say this. It is an honor to serve this wonderful group of young people. They really touched my heart just a few minutes ago. We just worshiping the Lord, you know, rehearsing. And just as our pastor talked about in the morning service about, I know my relationship with the Lord. And it's super important that we know that we have a personal relationship with the Lord. And as I watched them sing and they just zoned out and worshiped him, and I was just watching them and I was really touched. And so I just want to get to it and let's worship him together. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Morning glory. Hallelujah. You all I want.
I feel the presence of the Lord today. I don't know about you, but I just want to tell him.
You're all I want. Oh, we worship you. You're all I ever needed. You're all I want. Oh, Jesus, help me. Help me know when you are.
People I see, somebody say that in unison real quick.
So you all,
you're all I want.
Yes.
You all,
you're all I am.
Just lift your hands and love on him today.
You
all, you're all I want.
Help me, Lord, I want to know when you're near.
Help me know you.
Say it in harmony. Say it one more time.
You're all, you're all.
Let's love on Jesus today.
You're all.
Place
not with and I want to feel the warmth of your embrace. Oh, Jesus, help me find my way. Bring me back, you're all
I want.
Come on and lift your voice and say,
you're all I ever needed.
You're
all I want.
Help me know. Just one more time. Feel the presence of the Lord. You're all I want.
You're all I want.
Lord, we welcome you here today, God. We welcome your presence, Lord Jesus.
You're all I ever
needed. Oh, God, we welcome your presence.
You're all I want.
Yes, Lord, help me know.
Time.
Let's lift our voice one more time. You're all I want.
You're all I want.
Hallelujah.
You're all I ever needed. You're all I want. Help me know you.
Hallelujah. If you would stand to your feet. Hallelujah. As I present to some and introduce to others,
stay there.
Pastor, the bishop and founder of Perfecting Church, Bishop-elect Marvin Winans.
Oh, come on. Come on.
Oh,
you're all I want.
Hey,
you're all I ever need.
Oh, Lord, you're everything.
You're all I want.
Help me know you are there. Clap those hands. Let's give God praise for the Perfecting Youth Chorale. Hallelujah. I keep forgetting, I want the drummer to come out. Art, if you could get the... Come on over here, drummer, because we be thinking that's Chris playing the drum. That ain't Chris. There go Art. He holding it down. That's good right there. They got you on the camera. Let's hear it for Brother Deshaun. Amen. I like music. And I know when you're singing and when you're just thanking the Lord. And these young people are singing. I mean, I hear the difference. So we give God praise for Amir Andre Healy. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord for a few moments. I want to call your attention. We've been hearing nonstop over the news about the fires in Maui. And it's devastating.
and we have personal understanding, and there's a family that we've known for years. Some of you may know Sister and Paulie, their son, Steve. We just call him Boy. And he and his family miraculously escaped. He said they had like 2 minutes, and he grabbed up his family and only had what they, the clothes they had on their backs. And they got in the car and went to riding. And as they were driving, the fire was right behind them. And they saw where the cars had stopped. Folk were getting out of their cars, running into the ocean because of the fire. And as you hear daily, the death toll goes up. And he said he just grabbed people and put them in his car. And they were dodging the fire. And they have absolutely nothing. And some of you may have already given, but we want to give, and we praise God for sparing their lives. And there is, I don't know how to do this, but there is a GoFundMe link on our Perfecting Church's Facebook page, as well as my personal Facebook page. I do have one. And I want to give. I want you to give. No amount is too small. And I want to, and it will go directly to them. So you will be a personal blessing. All you have to do is go to the Facebook page, and there is a link on Perfecting's Facebook page for their GoFundMe account. And I want you to give. Amen. And, you know, let's let them know that we love them. Amen? Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It has been a busy week. I tell people, it seems like I thought when I got to a certain age that things would slow down. But it seems like I tell him every morning, renew my youth. And he's taking me up on that. So we praise God. And so I'm gonna, as Pastor Haynes, if he would come and give us the bread of life. Would you stand to your feet? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, you know he's got a word. Come on and give God praise, as he shall go as God leads him.
Hallelujah. Oh, let's give God the praise that he deserves. Come on and give him the praise that he deserves. Father, we thank you for your mercies and your grace. Thank you, Jesus. You're such a good God. We thank you for your word now. We pray, God, that you'd send your word from heaven. The grass withereth, and the flower thereof fadeth, but your word endures forever. Now send your enduring word, and we will give you the praise. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. The Lord is great and greatly to be praised. Oh, come on, let's give God praise. Hallelujah. He's greatly to be praised. Come on, a great God deserves a great praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, bless his name. We certainly honor our God today. He is the head of my life, and I praise him for being my God. How about you? Thank you, Jesus. We bless the name of the Lord. He is a great God. We praise God. We certainly honor our bishop today. Praise God for him. Come on, let's praise God for our man of God. God promised to give us shepherds after his own hearts that would feed us with the knowledge and understanding. And we thank God we're not lacking at perfecting, but we have a pastor that feeds us. Amen? God is so good. We praise God for Mother Winans. Oh, everyone that's here, come on, let's praise God for Mother Winans. Praise God for you. all our preachers, our ministers. Today we praise God for you, our elders, elect leader. I believe my wife is here. I praise God for my wife. I honor her today. Praise God. Let's go to the word of the Lord. I want to welcome everyone who's watching by way of streaming, by way of Facebook or YouTube. God is faithful to us. Let's go to the word of the Lord. Let's go to St. John, St. Matthew, the 9th chapter. And the 36th verse. Matthew 9 and 36. We praise God for the word this morning. Oh, it spoke personally. You ought to walk in the strength of God that we're not inferior. Hallelujah. How many love that word this morning? The enemy will make you feel that you're inferior, but you got to know who you are in God. Hallelujah. Matthew 9 and 36, if you have it, say amen. Amen. But when he saw the multitudes, that's talking about Jesus, when Jesus saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. Hallelujah. Let's go to Psalm 23. A very familiar passage of scripture. Psalm 23 and the 6th verse. Well, let me read the first verse. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. And the 6th verse, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My subject today is a shepherd like none other. Tell your neighbor, a shepherd like none other. Jesus, in Matthew, he saw the multitude and he was moved with compassion on them because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. Hallelujah. I know this is familiar, and the challenge of preaching something familiar is that you may fall asleep because you're so familiar with the story. You know, David wrote the psalm, and it's something that the children know. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. But it becomes to the believer something personal. I want to go to, as I was reading yesterday, Ezekiel, the 34th chapter. Because I went to the farmer's market yesterday, my wife and I, and we got some fruits and vegetables, some eggs. And as I was there, I began to think about Jesus, just being at the farmer's market, and his examples of how he used his surroundings to teach a lesson. He spoke to the farmer, the sower went out to sow a seed. And some fell on stony grounds, some fell on thorns, but the last ground was good ground. And I pray today that you would be awake and let the seeds fall on good grounds as we go shopping. Hallelujah. So Ezekiel 34 and the 6th verse, well, it's so much in here. And as I began to read Ezekiel, it was so much in there, just Ezekiel, I said, Lord, this must be the hardest book in the Bible because there's so many much imageries that he spoke about. But nevertheless, he spoke about the shepherd. And today we tell your neighbor, we have a shepherd like none other. He said, son of man, and he called Ezekiel so many times, son of man. And in the second verse, it says, son of man, prophesy against the shepherds of Israel. Prophesy and say unto them, thus said the Lord God unto the shepherds. Woe be to the shepherds. Woe be to the shepherds. Woe be to the shepherds of Israel that do feed themselves. Lord have mercy. See, the job of the shepherd is not to feed themselves, but to feed the flock of Israel that do feed themselves. Should not the shepherds feed the flocks? Hallelujah. And like I start out saying that God has given us a shepherd, a man after God's own heart that feeds us with knowledge. Aren't you glad for a shepherd that's concerned about your spiritual growth? Hallelujah. In the third verse, he said, ye eat the fat and ye clothe you with the wool. Ye kill them that are fed, but ye feed not the flock. The diseased have ye not strengthened. Hallelujah. Let me read that again. The diseased, talking about the diseased, the sheep, have ye not strengthened, neither have ye healed that which was sick. Lord, I thank you. Neither have ye bound up that which was broken, neither have ye brought again that which was driven away, neither have ye sought that which was lost, but the force and with force and with cruelty have ye ruled them. Lord, I thank you. Hallelujah. Oh, we have a shepherd today. Oh, God was just showing Ezekiel the shepherds of Israel that would abuse the sheep. They wouldn't do these things for the sheep. The sheep would be sick, but they wouldn't bind up the wounds on the sheep. But I could hear Isaiah crying out that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he had anointed me to preach good tidings. And Jesus, when he was here on earth, he picked it up. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach good tidings to those that are bound, those that are sick. He preached good tidings that you may be healed today. Those that are bound, he's here to make you loose today. Those that are in chains, he's here to free you today because he is a shepherd like none other. Hallelujah. We have a shepherd that cares about our every need. Thank you, Jesus. The disease have ye not strengthened, neither have ye healed that which was sick, neither have ye bound up that which was broken. See, a part of the job of the shepherd was not just to feed them, but to take care of them. Hallelujah. I got to go to Psalm. Just for a little bit. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. And that's the job of the shepherd. And I want you to know that this was not talking just about a natural shepherd, but this was talking about the shepherd from heaven, because when Jesus came, he said, I am the good shepherd. And the good shepherd, he gives his life for the sheep. Hallelujah. I think we ought to rejoice if you know that God has given his son, the good shepherd, for your life. You ought to praise him. You ought to give him the praise because he's given his life for your life. I said he's given his life for your life. He is the good shepherd. Hallelujah. Do we have any sheep in the pasture today? Hallelujah. You may be sick today, but he's here to bind up your wounds. You may be broken today, but he's here to heal you. You may be confused today, but he's here to set your mind at ease. Hallelujah. I'm talking about a shepherd like none other. I'm talking about Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The one that came through 42 generations. The one that said, let there be light, and there was light.
Hallelujah. I'm talking about the shepherd that walked on the waters. I'm talking about the shepherd, hallelujah, that cares for the sheep. I'm talking about the shepherd that leads you beside the still waters. I'm talking about the shepherd that knows your end from the beginning. I'm talking about the shepherd that knows how to feed you, not only feed you, but know how to lead you. I'm talking about that kind of shepherd. He'll give you life when you're down and out. All right, I want to bring this into context. I won't be long, but this shepherd, hallelujah, this shepherd, I want us to go to Ezekiel in that fifth verse. He said, let me slow down. The disease have you not strengthened, all right? Neither have you sought that which was lost, but therefore, with force and with cruelty have ye ruled them. I want you to know that God does not force himself upon you, but he is a free God. So freely receive and freely give. Hallelujah. God will give you himself if you open up to him. He will be your shepherd. I know you've been looking for a guide for a while, but he will be your guide. Hallelujah. You might need financial aid or financial assistance, financial guide, but he will be your guide. He will be your guide even unto death. He is that kind of shepherd that will give his life for the sheep. He will not treat you cruel. He will not cast you out of his presence. Hallelujah. You remember David that wrote the Psalm 23. But David, when he sinned with Bathsheba, and the prophet came to him and said, David, thou art the man. Hallelujah. David repented before God in the 51st Psalm. And he began to talk to God. Why? Because God would not cast him out. He said, cast me not away from thy presence. Hallelujah. You've been leading me all this time. I went through the dilemma with Saul, and Saul was after my life, but I found out God led me to the cave. I said, God led me to the cave, and he was my shepherd when Saul was after my life. He was my guide when Absalom tried to take the throne from me. God was with him, but David went through hard times, and you may be experiencing hard times today, but I want you to know that every phase of your life, that God will be with you. I want you to know that every step of your life, that God will be with you. He's not the God that will leave you in the dark, but he'll go through the dark with you. He'll go through the hard times with you. God will stand with you. God will be there with you. In sickness, he'll be with you. In health, he'll be with you. In the good times, he'll be with you. In the bad times, he'll be with you. He'll not set you up for failure, but God will be with you. Tell your neighbor, God will be with you. Hallelujah. Because he's that kind of shepherd. Hallelujah. My sheep wandered through all the mountains and upon every high hill. Yea, my flock was scattered upon all the face of the earth, and none did search to seek them out. But I want you to know today that he came to seek and to save that which was lost, because he's that kind of shepherd. He left the 99 and he found me. How about you? You hath he quickened, who were dead in trespasses and sins. I said, we were dead, have no hope within. But he came and he found us. We were lost. We were in the mire, wasn't thinking about God. But he came as the good shepherd. I got to leave the 99, and I got a son out there. I got a daughter out there, and he came and found you. Hallelujah. Our text, in our text, Jesus saw the multitude and he was moved with compassion on them. I said he was moved with compassion. Hallelujah. When no one else have compassion, the Lord will have compassion. the Lord will see you through. Hallelujah. Because they were sheep, they were faint. Have you ever been faint before? They were scattered abroad as sheep, having no shepherd. But I want you to know today, in any phase of life, that God will be with you. You don't have to be scattered abroad, but the word of God is right here with you. I said the word of God is right here with you, and he'll see you through. You may be going through a hard time, but hard times are nothing for your shepherd, because he'll lead you through the wilderness. When you go through the fire, God will be with you. When you go through the floods, the promise is that it will not overwhelm you. Hallelujah. But God will be with you in whatever phase of life, wherever you find yourself, God will be with you. I remember the three Hebrew boys when they went through their trials. Hallelujah. They refused to bow to the king. They refused and they say, oh king, we will not bow. I said, we will not bow. They told them, when you hear the sound of the music, then bow down and worship my God. But the Hebrew boys said, oh king, we will not bow. The king said, hallelujah. Well, you're going in the fiery furnace. Heat is seven times hotter. But he didn't know that they had a shepherd that was right there with them. He didn't know that the shepherd would be in the fire. Hallelujah. Heated the furnace seven times hotter and threw them in there. Hallelujah. But what I like about God, they though I walk through the valleys of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, because thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me like no other shepherd. Thy rod and thy staff, they begin to comfort the Hebrew boys. They went through the fire. Hallelujah. Seven times hotter. In the morning, the king arose and he looked in the furnace and he said, didn't we throw three in there? But I see four walking. The Bible told me that the smell of fire wasn't even on the boys. Why? Because they trusted God. Because God had brought them from a long way. And they were able to stand on the word of God. He saw one that looked like the Son of God. I said he saw one that looked like the Son of God. Whatever you're going through, the shepherd is right there with you. Why? He has compassion on you. You're not in it by yourself. You're not in it alone, but God is there with you. I said God is in it with you. In the furnace, God will be with you. As Daniel in the lion's den, and he'll be with you in the lion's den. He's that kind of shepherd. I'm closing. Hallelujah. But he makes me to lie down in green pastures. He doesn't lead me to the dry spots. But my shepherd look out for me in every situation. When the world is drying up, worrying about the economy, is green in my house. Why? Because the shepherd, he leads me in green pastures. Hallelujah. He leads me beside the still waters. He restored my soul every now and then. I feel a little weak, but let the weak say I'm strong, because he restored my soul. I said he restores my soul. Hallelujah. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. The devil wants you to fear, because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers. We wrestle against the rulers, the powers of the air. He's trying to put fear on you. But don't fear when you're going through the valley. Don't fear when you're going through the trials. He's right there with you. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Hallelujah. I wish I had time to talk about the table in the presence of mine enemies and the anointing of God. He anoint my head with oil and my cup running over. Then he says, surely I'm about to take my seat, but surely Can I talk about goodness and mercy a little bit? Goodness, it means it's following me, but it doesn't just follow me. It overshadows me. That word goodness, it means it brings a camp around me. You may think, look back, goodness is following me. Good, yes, it's following me, but he's not just following me. He's encamped about me. And the Bible tells me the angels of the Lord have encamped round about them that fall, that fear him. Hallelujah. Because I fear God, goodness is all around me. Because I fear God, I'm not afraid to go to the right. I'm not afraid to go to the left. Because I fear God, and goodness is all around me. Hallelujah. Goodness and mercy shall follow me. What I need is the mercies of God. Does anyone need his mercy today? Hallelujah. I know I've done some things, but I need the mercies of God. I know I've not been right all the time, but I need the mercies of God. I said mercy, mercy, hallelujah. The mercies of the Lord. Hallelujah. Rain on me, Lord. I want the mercies of God. Don't give me what I deserve, but give me what I don't deserve. Surely, I said surely, surely is not a maybe, but surely is positive. It means he is going to do it. Surely goodness and mercy. There's not a maybe in God, but surely goodness and mercy. It shall follow me, not just for 1 or 2 days. I don't know what you're thinking about. You may be young, now you got old. But David said, I've been young, but now I'm old. And I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Hallelujah. All the days of my life, I'm getting old, you may think, but God's mercy is still with you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You may be getting all kinds of things in your body, but the mercies of God is with you. He's on your life. He's on your life. Tell your neighbor, he's on my life. I said, he's on my life. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me, not some of the days, but all the days of my life. I said all the days of my life. And not only that, I'm going to stay here. I'm going to dwell in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I have no other pasture. Hallelujah. He feeds me. He leads me. And he guides me. Everyone standing. A shepherd. A shepherd like none other. Hallelujah. Jesus looked at his 12 after a multitude left him. And he looked at his disciples and said, will ye also go? And the spokesman, Peter, said, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. In other words, you're my shepherd like none other. I'm going to stay with Jesus. How about you? I said, I'm going to stay with Jesus. Come on. Father, we thank you for your word. And I pray that it has fallen in fertile soil that will bring forth fruit that will remain. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, put your hands together. If there's anyone here today who needs a shepherd, if you're here and you don't know Jesus Christ and the pardon of your sin, he's still your shepherd. He's been watching over you. If you're watching and you don't have a shepherd today, his compassion never fail. He had compassion on them because they were like sheep having no shepherd. But you don't have to leave this place without a shepherd. Preachers, will you come? If you're here and you don't have a shepherd, come on. We want to pray with you. If you're here and you're not saved, you don't know Jesus Christ and the pardon of your sin, he will save you. He will guide you. He'll be your guide even unto the end. Come at this time. If you're here, I want to be saved. I want to believe in Jesus. Come on. Come on, somebody. Praise God. I believe they're here. You don't have to leave the same way, but he'll fill you with the Holy Ghost, another comforter. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Save today. Even those that are watching, I pray that you release your spirit. Release the spirit of salvation. Cause them to know you as their shepherd. And that you know that they'll know that they're yours. Bless now, we pray and save. In Jesus' name. Come on, put your hands together. Let's say amen for our bishop.
Oh, y'all not praising him like you got a shepherd. My. He, that verse that Jesus quoted could be found in Deuteronomy 27 and 17. And the promise there is that he's going to put somebody over you that will go with you everywhere you go. That you won't be like a sheep without a... Then he said, if you read John 10, he talks about how he's the good shepherd.
Oh, yes.
Now, he said, I know my sheep by name. You might not know me. You know, you're starting to look for, keep talking, you're starting to look familiar. God knows me by name. And if I walk away from him, look, he'll seek me and try to find me. Now when he finds me, he doesn't fuss me. Didn't I tell you don't come over here no more? You know what he does? He grabs me and puts me on his shoulder. The shoulder is the place of power. So God puts me right on his shoulder. I shall not want. I shall not want. Cause my soul got a shepherd in the valley, and I shall not. Lord, have mercy. You know, that's when I heard them sing that, that's what wiped me out right there. Cause I shall not want. I shall not want. Cause my soul got a shepherd in the valley. Y'all don't want it. I shall not want. Say,
I shall not want.
Cause my soul.
Cause my soul's got a shepherd in the valley. And I shall not want.
Now, only if you mean it. You can sit down if you want to. But I just want the ones that know that they have a shepherd. No, I mean, you can sit down. Cause we ain't gonna look bad at you. But those that have a shepherd in the valley, throw your head back and sing like you got a contract. I shall not want. Come on.
I shall not want.
There we go.
I shall not want.
Tell me why.
For my soul's got a shepherd in the valley, and I shall not want.
Say it again, say it.
I shall not want.
Yeah, yeah.
I shall not.
Cause my soul got a shepherd.
My soul got a shepherd in the valley, and I shall not want.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I want our ushers to come. They prophesying on the news there's gonna be a recession, gas prices going through the roof. I want the gas prices to come down. I want eggs to come down, and definitely want chicken to come down. And but no matter how high it gets, I shall not
want. I shall not want.
Tell me why. I want everyone to get a seat in your hand. Stand all over the sanctuary with that seed. Hallelujah. Whoa! Those of you that are watching by way of streaming, I want you to invest in this word today. You got a shepherd. Now, hold on, because you don't know what's going to happen. You got a shepherd. Lift it up. Father, we honor you. We thank you for the opportunity to give. We stand amazed at your ability to take so little and to do so much with it. Now, Lord, bless both gift and giver according to their faithfulness and according to their cheerfulness. For it's not as a debt I owe, but as a seed I sow. Now, as you pass it down, just as it releases your hand.
Giving is our worship at Perfecting Church. You may sow the following ways. Cash App, $PC Detroit. Please add your name, address, and type of contribution in the notes. PC text to give is simple and secure. Text Perfecting to 73256. You can sow by Zelle. Use email pcdetroitzelle@gmail.com. Recipient, Perfecting Church. You may mail your contribution to Perfecting Church, 7616 East Nevada Street, Detroit, Michigan, 48234. If you are giving in person, giving is available by cash, check, or credit card. We pray Malachi 3:10 blessings upon you and your household. Thank you for your financial support to Perfecting Church. Good day, members and friends of Perfecting Church. It is time for the Perfecting News. Classes were great this morning in Academy to Perfection. There is a class for everyone. Sincere Milk, Paul the Apostle, Prayer 101, Position Ready, the Book of Esther, Mentor, and Teen classes for young ladies and young men. Secure your spot today. Sign up in the chapel or at academy@perfectingchurch.org. Perfecting Church will give away food Tuesday. Meet us at the Care Center at 1 p.m. Get enough food for you and your family. Ministry means people. The week is finally here. Day of Stewardship with Mr. David Stewart is Saturday, and we can hardly wait. Purchase Leadership by the Good Book from the bookstore and have it signed Saturday at the Forum. We encourage one and all to attend Day of Stewardship. The Perfecting Church transportation is back in action. If you are in need of a ride to Sunday service, all you need to do is contact Perfecting Church. Call 313-36-JESUS Monday through Thursday, and we will do the rest. We are here to serve you. We are preparing our heart and spirit for a miraculous day of giving. Perfecting Church will consecrate tomorrow, Tuesday, and Wednesday. We will fast one meal a day after 5 p.m. Prayer will be at Perfecting Church at 6 a.m., noon, and 7 p.m. Everyone is asked to join in this special time of consecration. Next Sunday is Day of Giving. Members and friends of Perfecting Church, we are ready. We are excited to complete our new church on 7 Mile in Woodward. We are believing for 1,000 people to sow $1,000. Perfecting, this is our church, so let's meet and exceed our goal at Day of Giving. Please give your attention to the video announcement from the dance department. Parents, you may secure your child's place following service in the corridor.
Had the privilege of having three of my girls transition through Perfecting Church Dance Ministry. They have grown tremendously. They have been able to minister in dance. They have seen their gifts blossom in the capacity that is beyond imagination. Their lives have absolutely changed for the better. It has been a joy watching them grow, watching them share with one another, pour back into one another, and just letting God use them. Perfecting Church Dance Ministry has changed their lives, and I encourage other parents to get involved. Let your girls join, let them blossom, and let them explore life from a whole nother perspective. Perfecting Church Dance Ministry is amazing, and I can't wait to see what's next.
My daughter started out, she was a little shy, and dancing was not her forte as far as like being perfect, but at the same time with Sister Brittany and Sister Tammy, working with her, she has blossomed to become a beautiful young lady and also just encourage her spiritual walk with Christ.
The fact that I can do this art and express myself of how God has been good to me and my whole family is really good.
The conservatory is what we need. As a parent with my daughter wanting to get her involved in extracurricular activities, I'm very cautious about what she's exposed to. So I feel that having the conservatory here at our ministry is perfect. They can learn and have fun, get the technical part as well as getting the spiritual part. I am so excited for the conservatory to start.
I'm really excited about conservatory and the new outreaches that we will be able to pursue in New Generation.
Being a part of the Perfecting Church Dance Department since I was 12 and now being 19 has allowed me to grow so much, as in being a choreographer, a teacher, a leader, and then just growing and knowing that dance is accepted and it's powerful, that it communicates with God and He hears you. Just being raised in the dance department and growing alongside Sister Brittany and Sister Tammy, and I'm very grateful for the Perfecting Church Dance Department.
The Perfecting Church Dance Department is delighted to introduce the conservatory. This facet of the department is focused solely on dance education, offering various genres of dance for ages 6 to adult. This endeavor is open to the congregation as well as the community. We see a strong need for quality dance education in the sacred space, and we're here to fill that void. So if you are called to the ministry of dance, if you're a dance enthusiast, or just looking for a safe place for your child to be exposed to dance and ministry, PC Conservatory is here for you. Hope to see you there.
Perfecting Church.